क्वेश्चन नहीं बता रहा।
गुड आफ्टरनून एवरी वन डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट सम ऑफ नीट क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम टू टॉपिक्स, दैट इज प्रिंसिपल ऑफ इनहेरिटेंस एंड वेरिएशन। द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज द क्रॉस बिटवीन कैपिटल ए कैपिटल ए स्मॉल कैपिटल बी एंड स्मॉल बी विथ स्मॉल ए कैपिटल बी स्मॉल बी यील्ड्स these four kind of offerings. Then they are asking the ratio, and it is very easy, and you should go for crossing. And from these two parents we produce gametes, and these are the homozygous. Instead of two alleles I will take one, and what are the gametes we will produce here? This is capital A, capital B is a one gamete, another one is capital A small b. These are the two gametes we have obtained from this parent. Second one is from here small a capital B small a small b. These are four gametes we got from these two parents. Now we can cross it. If you cross, what we will get? You will get four kind of generations. What we will get? And this gametes fused with this one, what we will get? We will get this kind of progeny. This is the one. Second one is capital A, capital B, small b. Third possibility, capital A, small a, capital B, small b. And fourth possibility, capital A, capital B, capital B, small b, small b. Now we got four generation or four offerings. Here what is the ratio? And this kind of generations we have found only one, and this is about what? Two. And this kind is one, but small a, small b, these are absent. Then which is the correct answer? 1:2, 2:2, 1:0, that is the correct answer. That is second one. And next one is second question. How many types of gametes are expected from the organism which genotype is capital A, capital B, capital C. These are in homozygous conditions. From these two allele we will get one allele, from these two we will get take one, and these two alleles will get one allele. When you cross these three, what you will get? You will get only one gamete which consists of A, B, C. You won't get any gametes because these are in homozygous condition. That's why first one is the correct answer. And third question. Mrs. Verma has autosomal gene pair capital B, small b, and she contains X-linked gene D. What is the percentage of gamete which containing BD genes? And they're asking, and this woman, she has autosome what? Capital B and small b, and she also having X linked gene, that is the T, and female having 2X chromosomes. That's why I have written 2D genes. During gamete formation, these two alleles they will separate during gamete formation. What you will get? You will get this is the one kind of gamete, and this is another kind of gametes. They are asking what is the percentage of small b and small d. This is about what? Small b and small d. Total, we got two gametes. Out of two gametes, small b and small d is one. That's why 50% of small b and small d and 50% of capital B and small d. That's why, which is the correct answer here? That is first one. And next question is, which of the following is example for codominance? As we know that for codominance, the example is human blood group, that is AB blood group, not A, not B, not O. AB blood group is only one example for codominance. And these two alleles are under, these are produced by the alleles, that is IA and IB. This is the example for what? Codominance. And out of these four options, where we got this kind of frequency here, option 1, 2, 3, but 4 is not correct answer. Now we can search among these three. And also we have studied sickle cell anemia. Sickle cell anemia is also an example for codominance. And which is out of these three options, which one shows sickle cell anemia? That is third one, HbA and HbS and IA and IB. These are example for codominance. And first we should identify based on the AB blood group, later based on sickle cell anemia. This is the one hint we can easily identify codominance. Later, fifth question. Crossover value of gene A and B is 5%. Crossover value of gene B and C is 15%. The possible sequence of these three genes on chromosome is, actually they are asking based on gene mapping. Here you should take, this is a one chromosome. In this chromosome, how many genes are located? Three genes, A, B, and C. They also mentioned frequency, or they have given the distance. This is the A gene, this is the B gene. What is the distance between A and B? That is 5. That is 5%. And there is another gene, that is C. Between the B and C is about 15%. Then they are asking, what is the sequence of these genes on the chromosome? And first there is a possibility is A, later B, next one is C. This is a one sequence. Also it is found in another sequence, that is in reverse manner, that is C, B and A. Then what is the possible sequence of these three genes on the chromosome? That is ABC, and another one is CBA. That is about what? CAB or CBA. That is what? Second one. Both 1 and 2 are correct answer. That is the fourth one is the correct answer. Next one is, a colorblind man marries a daughter of colorblind father. Then what about the offerings? It is very easy. And just to take colorblind man. Man has XY chromosome. He is a colorblind because colorblindness is a sex-linked disorder. Later he married with daughter of colorblind father. Daughter, but her father was colorblind. Because of colorblind, I have written with C. And this daughter got one X chromosome from the father. Out of two X chromosome, one get affected. This is the phenotype, genotype of these two individuals. Now we should go for what? Gamete formations. From the parents, you will get like this, XC and Y, and from these are the two gametes. Now you will cross, you will get the sequence. What you will get? This is XC. It is what? Affected, isn't it? Next, this is what? Carrier, and these two are female. In second case, what happens? This is X with defected chromosome, this is the Y, and this is the XY. In out of four, two are female. Out of two, one is affected, one is carrier. In case of male, out of two male, one get affected, one is normal. That means, which is the correct answer? The first one, all sons are colorblind? No. Second, all daughters are colorblind? No. One is normal, one is carrier is present. Next, third one, all sons are colorblind? Of course, it is the correct answer. And no daughters is colorblind? It is wrong, because one daughter is colorblind. That's why third is the correct answer. The next one is seventh one. A hybrid is generally more vigorous than either of the parents. This is due to. Here, hybrid we obtained by crossing of two superior organisms. When we cross two superior organisms, it can produce us heterozygosity organism. And because of this heterozygosity, hybrid having desirable characters. That's why second one is the correct answer. And homozygosity, it cannot produce us vigorous hybrid either of the parents. It is wrong. And mixing of cytoplasma, it is known as plasmogamy. It is also leads to the syncytium. It is also not correct answer. For this, heterozygosity is responsible for production of more vigorous hybrid. And next one is, it is a direct question. Gene that shows its effects on more than one character. When single gene produces more effect, that is known as what? Pleiotropy. For this pleiotropy, the example is what? Sickle cell anemia. Sickle cell anemia is example for pleiotropic gene. Then what about polygene? In polygene, it is reverse. In polygene, many genes regulate one phenotype or one character, that is known as polygene. This polygene is also known as multiple gene, and multifactor is also give the same meaning of polygene or multiple gene. That's why when single gene produce more than two or one character, that is example for pleiotropic gene. Second one is the correct answer. And next, ninth question. Which of the following scientist name is correctly matched with theory put forth by them? That means they have given four scientist name. You must match with their theories. One is Hugo de Vries. It is proposed by Hugo de Vries. He proposed natural selection. It is wrong. Hugo de Vries proposed mutation theory. And Mendel, they have given theory of pangenesis. Actually, pangenesis is produced by the Charles Darwin. And Mendel proposed law of segregation, independent assortment, etc. And next one is Weismann. He proposed theory of continuity of germplasm. This is the correct answer. And Louis Fascher, he proposed theory of biogenesis. And that's why it is also wrong. inheritance of acquired characters proposed by Lamarck. That's why, which is the correct answer here? Third one is the correct answer, because Weismann, he proposed theory of continuity of germ plasma. This theory disproved the theory of inheritance of acquired characters proposed by the Lamarck. Next one is Mendelian ratio 9:3:3:1 is due to. Dear students, here 9:3:3:1, it is the ratio of what? Dihybrid cross. And this dihybrid cross you have studied in law of independent assortment. Law of independent assortment explains dihybrid cross. It is the genotypic ratio of what? It is a phenotypic ratio of what? Independent assortment. And law of segregation is also known as purity of gametes. What do you mean by law of unit character means? And Mendel says every organisms, they having a characters, isn't it? These characters are controlled by the factor, and these factor always present in the pair, and this law is known as law of unit characters. But this ratio we will get in law of independent assortment. That's why third is the correct answer. And next one is 120 plants are produced on crossing of pure red and pure white. White flowered pea plants, this ratio is. Then what is the answer here? It is based on monohybrid cross. As per the Mendel, when you cross homozygous two plants, in F1 generation you got all tall plant. Like this, if you go for crossing pure red, that is represented with capital R, capital R, and white, smaller and smaller. Now we should go for gametes. Okay, if you cross these four gametes, what we will get? You will get heterozygous red, heterozygous red, heterozygous and heterozygous. In F1 generation, what is the possibility? There is a four offerings we have, but these four offerings, they having what? Red color. That's why fourth is the correct answer. And next one is, when dominant and recessive alleles express itself together, it is called as codominance, dominance, amphidominance, pseudodominance. Which is the correct answer here? Here, when two alleles, it may be dominant or recessive alleles, they can express together, that is known as codominance. For this codominance, already we have given the example of what? Human blood group, especially AB. And sickle cell anemia is also example for codominance. Then what do you mean by dominance? When allele express its character, that is known as dominance. Here, what do you mean by pseudo-dominance? In pseudo-dominance, what happens? Due to mutation, dominant allele get deleted or get eliminated, then the recessive allele mimic the dominant one, and that is known as pseudo dominance. But actually pseudo dominance and amphi and these are not there in our syllabus, and based on this definition we can easily guess first is the correct answer. Codominance is the exact answer. And next question, it is based on pedigree analysis, and study the pedigree chart given below. What does it shows? And first of all, by seeing any kind of pedigree, first we should guess whether it is a sex linked or autosomal disorder. And there is one small hint is there. In case of sex linked, what happens? if father get affected, the daughter also get affected. In sex-linked diseases, both father and daughter get affected. That is the one hint. In this pedigree, can you guess? Father is normal, but daughter is also get affected. That means it is not a sex-linked diseases. Then wherever sex-linked diseases are there, you can eliminate. This one is wrong, and second is also wrong. What is remaining? Third one is the correct answer. The question is, in this pedigree, you must analyze whether it is a recessive characters or dominant. There is another small hint. If you want to identify whether it is a recessive trait or a dominant trait, means in a dominant trait, every stage get affected. For example, in F1 generation, one parent get affected, in F2 also get affected, in third generation also get affected. In all generation, if any parents or any offerings get affected, that is dominant trait. But there is a skipping. Parents are normal, but progeny is affected. Same, parents are normal and progenies get affected. That's why this pedigree explains inheritance of condition like phenylketonuria as an autosomal recessive trait. And that's why third is the correct answer. Next, what is the inheritance of color blindness? Both parents having normal vision, but mother has recessive gene for color blindness. And also you can use genotypic ratio. Here, what is the condition? Both parents having normal vision. There is a father having normal vision, and mother is also having what? Normal vision. This is the mother. This is the father. But what they have given? Mother, she has recessive gene. When she has a recessive gene, because and color blindness, it is a sex-linked disorders. That's why I have written with what? C. Now, we should go for gamete formations. What we will get? In male, these two gametes are produced. In female, these two. When you cross, what you will get? This is about carrier female. This is normal female. This is the normal. This is carrier. But here, if it is a colorblind male, it is a normal male. Here, out of two female, one is carrier, one is normal. In case of male, out of two, one is get affected. Then what is the possibilities? Out of two son, one son get affected. That's why 50% of son get affected when this kind of condition. That's why first one is the correct answer. And 15th question. Independent assignment of genes does not take place when? They're asking when, in which condition genes are not segregated. They have given four conditions. First, you should go through. Genes are located on homologous chromosomes. We can easily segregate. For example, we can take, this is a one gene. This is one chromosome. This is another. These are homologous chromosome. If these genes are present on homologous chromosome, we can easily segregate. That's why it is not correct answer. Second one, genes are linked and located on same chromosome. You should take, this is the one chromosome. There is a presence of what? Genes. These two genes are present on the same chromosome. Because of this linkage, we cannot segregate. That's why an independent assignment of gene does not take place when genes are linked and located on the same chromosomes. We can separate when chromosomes are, when genes are present on non-homologous chromosomes. And there is a possibility in one and third, we can separate the genes, but not in the second statement. That's why second is the correct answer. 16. Which of the following is example of pleiotropic gene? About the pleiotropic genes already we have discussed, that is sickle cell anemia, and because of mutation, point mutation, it can produces various phenotype. That's why sickle cell anemia is example for pleiotropic gene. And 17th question. When cluster of genes show linkage behavior, that means when group of genes, they can show a linkage, what will happen? That is, they do not show chromosome mapping. Of course, they can show the chromosome mapping. It is wrong. Okay, when group of genes are present, it become linked, means we can draw the chromosome mapping. And next, show the recombination during meiosis. Actually, they cannot show, they can show less recombination where there is a more linkage. Second one is also wrong. Next one, fourth one, induce cell division. And cell division, it is not depending upon any linkage. That's the fourth is also wrong. But here, and when cluster of genes show the linkage behavior, they do not show independent assortment. Means, on a chromosome, if any group of genes are present on the same chromosome, these genes, they cannot be separate. That's why third is the correct answer. And here, next one, industrial melanism is example of, as we know that industrial melanism is example for natural selection. Okay, but they are not given the natural selection in option, but we can give another example, that is camouflage. Industrial melanism is example for natural selection as well as camouflage. What do you mean by camouflage? The organisms, they can match their body color with respect to surroundings. And that's why, and out of this, industrial melanism is best example for protective resemblance with surroundings, not for drug resistance. Darkening of skin due to smoking of industry is also not, and defensive adaptation is not connected to the answer. That's why industrial melanism is example for camouflage, and this camouflage is give the definition of protective resemblance with the surroundings. Next one, when pregnant woman who has done amniocentesis test finds an extra bar body in her embryo, the syndrome which is likely to be. And dear students, here you should remember, when they can use bar bodies, it is related to sex chromosome. It is related to sex chromosome. And here, out of these four syndrome, which syndrome is connected to the sex-linked disorder? Edward, it is autosomal disorder. Down syndrome is also autosomal. And Pachu syndrome, these are also autosyndromes. But here, Klinefelter syndrome is a sex-linked disorder. In this, we will get what? Extra bar bodies. Like this, you can take, it is a gamete. And male having what? XY. In female, there is a presence of what? Extra. In case of Klinefelter syndrome, there is a presence of what? Extra X chromosome. This is extra chromosome, that is nothing but Bohr body. That is about what? Bohr body. And that's why, and Bohr bodies we have noticed in Klinefelter syndrome, not Edward, Down and Pachu syndrome. This way, third is the correct answer. Next one. Gametes are never hybrid. This statement of here, and gametes are never hybrid because, as we know that during gametogenesis, gametes will be segregate. How they will segregate? For example, you can take X and X, Okay, in this condition what happens? This one X chromosome segregated into one egg, and this another X chromosome segregated into another, and this two separation of two alleles is followed by the law of segregation. That's why third is the correct answer. It won't explains law of dominance and random fertilization and independent assortment, because gametes are never hybrid because of what? Law of segregation. And this question is already we have discussed in earlier. Albinism and phenylketonuria are the disorders due to, because it is not a sex linked disorder, that's why fourth and third are not correct. And phenylketonuria, it is a autosomal recessive disorder because there is the absence of enzyme, it won't convert some phenyl content in the body. That's why, and one is the correct answer. In 22nd, given below pedigree chart showing inheritance of certain sex linked trait in humans. Here you should identify what are the options they have given. They have given dominant X linked, recessive X linked, dominant V linked, recessive V linked. In these options, easily we can eliminate third and fourth because we are not studied like this V linked or Y linked diseases. And first of all, you should analyze in between 1 and 2. It is a sex linked, already we know that, because father get affected means daughter also got affected here. We can see any conditions. When father affected and this chromosomes get transmitted to the daughter, daughter also get affected. If mother get affected, sons get affected. This is the one hint you should identify. It is a sex linked diseases. Now our question is whether it is a dominant trait or recessive trait, whether it is a dominant or it is a recessive. And based on this hint, we can easily identify. In every generation, if any one progeny get affected means that is a dominant. Here in first one generation, male get affected. In second generation, female get affected. In third generation, both male and female get affected. Continuous any in generation, if continuous affected condition is present, that is the dominant case. If it is skipping, that is recessive. That's why this pedigree explains dominant X linked diseases. Next, which of the following is example for sex linked inheritance? Already we know that color blindness is a sex linked inheritance, and in case of male as well as female, but it is more in the male. And color blindness, it is occurs due to deficiency of vitamin A. And anemia, it is occurs due to mutation or deficiency of iron supplement. And cretinism is occurs due to hypothyroidism. That is what? Hypothyroidism. And that is the main reason. That's why, and anemia, cretinism and night blindness, these are not sex linked. Only color blindness is a sex linked diseases. And about these questions already we have learned in fifth question, that is distance between two linked genes upon a chromosome is measured in unit of what? Crossover values. For example, this is a one chromosome. This is the location of A gene. This is the location of B gene. This is the location of C gene, isn't it? And this distance measured by the unit, that is crossing over. About this already we have learned in the earlier question. And next one is XO chromosome or XO chromosomal abnormality in human being causes. It is Turner syndrome or Down, Jacob or Klinefelter. And Klinefelter syndrome, we got that there is a presence of Bohr body. That it is not correct answer. and XO it is related to sex linked, and this Down syndrome is autosomal disorder. That's why second is also wrong. And Jacob, in this condition, what happens? Male having what XY chromosome. In Jacob disease, in syndrome, there is a presence of extra Y chromosome. And this may be noticed, those individuals shows very high tall and some other abnormality characters. But here, in Turner syndrome, what happens? In case of female, presence of 2X chromosome due to failure of segregation of chromosomes, what happens? There is a presence of only 1X chromosome. That is the characteristic of what? Turner syndrome. That's why first is the correct answer. And these are the questions from evolution topic. And which of the following is not found in free state of during origin of life? In evolution topic, already we have learned. And in prebiotic atmosphere, there is no availability of what? Oxygen. Apart from oxygen, there is a presence of ammonia, methane, and hydrogen with water vapors. But in prebiotic atmosphere, there is no presence of oxygen. That's why third is the correct answer. According to the recapitulation theory, and this recapitulation theory is also known as biogenetic law. This law was proposed by Ernst Haeckel. And this Ernst Haeckel says that during development of organisms, they can repeat their ancestral characters. And that is evolutionary characters or ancestral characters. And that meaning was given by the fourth option. Ontogeny means it is related to the development aspects. Phylogeny means it is related to the evolution. And what recapitulation theory explains? It explains during development of the organism, it repeats their ancestral characters. For example, you should take, and human beings, we have the lungs as a respiratory organ, isn't it? But when human was in embryo stage, we have gills. And gills leads is the characteristic of what? Fishes, amphibians, reptiles. And human beings, during embryonic development, we are expressing our ancestral character, that is known as biogenetic law, is also known as recapitulation theory. That's why, and recapitulation theory is explains ontogeny repeats phylogeny. That's why fourth is the correct answer. Yes, theory of evolution is mainly concerned with spontaneous generation, theory of special creation, condition of environment, gradual changes. As we know that theory of evolution is always slow, gradual changes by taking long period of time. That's why evolution is concerned with gradual changes. And special creation is told about life is created by the God. And spontaneous generation, it is also known as abiogenesis, proposed by Aristotle. And that's why, and evolution is mainly concerned with gradual changes. In 29 questions, which of the following set has homologous organs? Dear students, we know the definition of homologous organ is, these are the organs, they having same origin, same anatomical structure, but performing different function, isn't it? Out of four options, you should search what are the group of organs they can show different function. Those are what? Homologous organ. And wings of birds and bats, they can use for flying. That's why these are analogous organ. Wings of insect and bird, also example for analogous. But butterfly wings and wings of birds and bats, they also performing same function, that is flying. But wings of bat and human hand, they can performing different function. That's why second one is example for homologous organ. And wings of bats, they helps in flying, and human hand is necessary for to perform various work, holding, chopping, etc. And Darwin's theory of natural selection was based on, as we know that, and natural selection, this concept was given by the Darwin, and this theory explains about what are the basic concept. Now, first one, inheritance of acquired characters, it is not, because it is proposed by the Lamarck. And mutation, it is also not correct answer, because it is proposed by the Hugo Dewris. And fourth one, changes due to use and disuse, this concept was also given by the Lamarck. But Darwin, theory of natural selection was completely based on production of organisms, or it is also known as overproduction and struggle for existence and survival for the fittest. And this is the third one, is the answer for 30 question. The weakest point of Darwin was it had no explanation. And Darwin, when he proposed different kind of theories, he told about struggle for existence, survival for fittest, and enormous rate of production is also known as overproduction. But Darwin, he did not explain about origin of variation, how organisms they can change from one generation to another generation. That variation did not explained by the Darwin. That's why third is the correct answer. In 32 question, evolution of birds and mammals occurred in, they have given certain periods as well as epochs, in which period these birds and mammals are appeared. And first of all, in Eocene and Oligocene periods, we noticed there is a grazing animals are present in this Oligocene period. In Silurian and Devonian period, there is a presence of what? Fungus and some of the arthropoda. And Carboniferous and Permian epochs, there is a presence of what? Vascular plants. And these plants are very small, or it may be very tall. But in Jurassic period, there is a presence of birds as well as the mammals. Because and Jurassic period is a golden era of reptiles, and these reptiles evolved into birds as well as mammals. That's why in this Jurassic period there is occurrence of what? Birds as well as the mammals. That's why fourth is the correct answer. And 33, the first ancestor of man whose fossils have been recovered was, or discovered was, actually first we have discovered the fossils of what? Australopithecus in the year 1924, and that is the correct answer. And this fossil was mainly discovered by the Raymond. He's a scientist, he discovered this Australopithecus. Next, scientific name of Java man is, and Java man and Peking man, these are comes under Homo erectus. That's why Homo erectus and erectus and Pithecotrampus erectus, these are the scientific name of what? Java man. That's why fourth option is the correct answer. largest cranial capacity was found in? Here, Peking man and Jawa man, these are called as Homo erectus. Their brain capacity is about 900 cc, isn't it? And Neanderthal man has 1400 cc. And Cro-Magnon has more than 1600 cc. Then out of these four, which ape has more large cranial capacity? That is Cro-Magnon. That's why fourth is the correct answer. Next one is 36. Theory of special creation has three connotations, means meanings. Which of the following is not true? They have given four options. Out of four, one is not explaining theory of special creation. What is that? That is, the diversity was always same since the creation and will be the same in future also. It is also correct, told by the special creation. Earth is about 4000 years old. It is also correct. Species are immutable, means species are constant always. And there has been gradual evolution life of form, and this is not told by the special creation. That's why, which is the correct answer? And fourth one is the correct answer. Remaining are wrong because it is not explained by the special creation. Changes of light colored variety of peppered moth, distant Butylaria, to its darker variety is due to, because you might be seen in the industrial melanism, peppered moth having what? Dark variety, dark color. What is the main reason? The main reason is mutation. And mutation of single gene, these organisms, they can show dark in color. That is the main scientific reason for natural selection in peppered moth. That's why, which is the correct answer here? Mutation of single Mendelian gene for survival in smoke-laden industry environment. That's why fourth is the correct answer. And 38. When more than one adaptive radiations appear to have occurred in isolated geographical area is called. And they are telling that there is one isolated area, and this isolated area having different adaptation. When they having different adaptation in isolated area, that is example for convergent evolution. In divergent evolution, what happens? There is a same adaptations. Anthrozoonic evolution, for that example is peppered moth. Okay, saltation, it is single step large mutation, it is not connected. That's why 38 second is the correct answer. Next one, what evolved into first amphibians? And as per the evolution, we know that lobe fin fish is the example for evolved into first amphibians, because these fish, their limbs are made up of bone, is a one characters, and another one is these are mainly having lungs. They having mainly lungs. Because of these lungs, they can live in land. They can live on land, or they can live in moist place. This is the main reason. And lobed fin fish, they are evolved into first amphibians. And this is the 40th question. And this diagram is totally based on theory of natural selection. And first of all, this diagram, it explains stabilization. In stabilization, the nature will be select intermediate characters. That is the one. Second one is the directional selection. In this, the organism, they can select only extreme characters. Third one is disruptive. In disruptive, the nature will be select on both extreme characters. That's why third is the correct answer. And 41, North American prairies were habitat for millions of greater prairie chickens. In Illinois alone, Illinois is a state of what? One region. There is a number of plummeted from about 100 million of birds in 1900 to 50 in 1990. The declining in the population resulted from hunting and habitat destruction. But random consequence has been loss of most of the species' genetic diversity. DNA analysis comparing the birds from the mid-century to birds in 1990 documents a step decline in the genetic variation. And in just a few decades, currently the greater prairie chicken is experiencing low reproductive success. What is the main reason? The main reason is genetic drift or bottleneck effect. And this bottleneck effect is applicable on when most of population get destroyed. In population, most of population get become destroyed, and it is applicable for what? Genetic drift or bottleneck effect. And this founder effect, it is applicable for smaller population which are isolated. In some extent, bottleneck effect and founder effect, they will give the same meaning, but slight variation is genetic drift or bottleneck effect is operating when the most population get destroyed. Because in Illinois, you may be noticed in 1900 there is a presence of 100 million of birds. In 1990, there is only 50, because there is a drastic destroying of what? Population. Which of the following statements are correct? It is based on the evolution during the development of organisms. Amphibians evolved into reptiles. It is correct. Fish with the snout and strong fins could move on land and go back to water. This is about 350 million years ago. It is also correct. Giant ferns were present, but they fell to form a coal or deposited slowly. It is also correct. About 65 million years ago, the dinosaurs are suddenly disappeared from the earth. It is also correct. And Archaeopteryx is the connection link between birds and reptiles. This is also correct. All the statements are what? True. That's why first is the correct answer. And match the column 1 with column 2. And select the correct option. And here, this prehistoric cave art found in past 18,000 years ago. And agriculture we have practiced past 10,000 years back. And Neanderthal man, he was found in past 40,000 to 1 lakh years ago. And Homo erectus is found past 1.5 million years ago. Then which is the correct answer? 1, 2, 1, 3, 4, 3. And third is the correct answer. And this is the select the correct statement. Microbial experiment shows the pre-existing advantageous mutations when selected will result in the observation of new phenotype over a few generation. This would result in speciation. It is also correct, because during experimentation, if benefited mutation takes place and these microorganisms are evolved into new species, that's what is known as speciation. That's what is also correct. Neanderthal fossils represent the human relatives. It is also correct, because it is present past 40,000 to 1 lakh years ago. In 1938, fish caught in South Africa happened to be coelacanth, is also known as no fin, which was thought to be extinct. These animals evolved into first amphibians living in both land and water. It is also correct answer. Lichens can be used as a water pollution indicator. That is wrong. It is used as a air pollution. It is indicator of what? Air pollution. That's why fourth one is the wrong. Alfred Valence is a naturalist who worked in Malaya archipelago, has also came to similar conclusion on natural selection. was reached by the Darwinism. That's why here all the statements are correct except fourth one. That's why 1, 2, 3, and 5 is the correct answer. Second is the correct answer. And last question, it is also as the following questions. And here, human embryo having gills, it explains endogeny recapitulates phylogeny. One is the fourth. Where is fourth? One is wrong. Second one is wrong. Third one and fourth, these are the two. And Oparin and Haldane, they explained about the theory of chemical evolution. And Miller, he explained about the stimulation of experiment. And for analogous organ, examples are wings. Which is the correct answer here? For 1 is 4, and 2 is 1, and 3 is 2, and 4 is equal to 3. And that's why 3rd is the correct answer. And this is about what? Questions regarding with evolution topic. Thank you.